In Russia, an outspoken Christian preacher is facing trial for posting a question on social media. Eduard Sharov asked, would Jesus Christ have gone to kill in Ukraine? He also reportedly called President Putin the Antichrist. He's set to stand trial on charges of discrediting the Russian armed forces. His case reflects the rising persecution of Christians in Russia and in Russian-occupied Ukraine. Christian leaders have been disappeared, tortured, and murdered for taking a Christian stand in what looks worryingly like a return to the bad old days of Christian persecution under the Soviet Union. 53-year-old Sharov fully expects to face a jail term of up to 7 years. He said, I will continue to help people in prison. There are people in need everywhere. And his wife, Inna, told the media, you can sit it out, keep quiet without attracting the attention of the authorities, but you will still answer to God. You should not fear the judgment of people, but of God. Another church leader has just been released from jail after completing a sentence for denouncing Russia's war against Ukraine. Ioan Kurmoyarov made YouTube videos criticizing the Russian Orthodox Church for supporting the invasion. Describing their support as demonic, Kurmoyarov stated, blessed are the peacemakers. Russia tightened its laws after the invasion of Ukraine to try to prevent all opposition against the war. Since then, church leaders who rock the boat have faced intimidation in the form of warnings, prosecution, and fines for any who publicly oppose Russia's war with Ukraine. In Russian-occupied areas of Ukraine, some church leaders have been tortured and killed. In February, the body of a Ukrainian Orthodox priest was found in the streets of Russian-occupied Kherson. And in November 2023, a Pentecostal deacon and his 19-year-old son were kidnapped and killed there. UK-based Release International is supporting Christian workers in occupied and disputed areas of Ukraine. They're supporting vulnerable families and offering trauma healing.